In this video, I'm going to use JASP to conduct a single sample mean t-test. Here I have the student survey short data set open. These data were collected from a sample of college students enrolled in one large introductory statistics course. We're going to assume that this sample is representative of the population of all students at this university. The research question I'm going to address is the mean height in the population of all students at this university different from 70 inches? The first thing I'll do is look at some descriptive statistics. There's just one variable that we're interested in here, and that is height. The default is to provide information about the sample size, mean, standard deviation, minimum, and maximum. Under statistics, I usually like to also ask for at least the quartiles, interquartile range, median, and mode. I have a valid sample size of 355. There were 7 students who did not report their height, so their data are missing. Then we have the mean, median, mode, and all of the other statistics that we requested. Under plots, I'll ask for what JASP calls a distribution plot. This is usually referred to as a histogram. This histogram is approximately normally distributed. Now, let's move on to conduct the single sample mean t-test to see if there's evidence that the mean height in the population is different from 70 inches. I'll go to t-tests, one sample t-test. The variable we're testing is height. As soon as we move that variable over, we get some output, but this is based on the default settings, which we'll need to make some changes to. The t-tests we're doing this week are sometimes called students' t. This is the default in JASP. The Wilcoxon signed rank test is a non-parametric test, which can be used if assumptions aren't met, but we won't be covering that in this course. The z-test is the test that we covered last week. That's used when the population is known to be normally distributed and you have the population standard deviation. But this week we're doing a single sample mean t-test, so we'll just check student. The test value is the number in our hypotheses. We want to know if the population mean is different from 70. Our null hypothesis is that the mean is 70. And the alternative hypothesis is that the mean is not 70. Our test value is going to be 70, so we need to change that here. As soon as we change that, the output on the right will update. Next, we'll look at the alternative hypothesis. The default in JASP is to conduct a two-tailed test, which is what we have in this case. If you were doing a right-tailed or a left-tailed test, this is where you would tell JASP that information. I usually skip the assumptions check here. Because our sample size is large, the sampling distribution will be approximately normal regardless of the shape of the sample. Location estimate will give us the sample mean, and confidence interval will give us the 95% confidence interval for the population mean. To interpret this, I am 95% confident that the mean in the population of all students at this university is between 67.997 inches and 68.848 inches. Effect size is Cohen's d. But in the latest versions of JASP, this is computed as the sample mean divided by the sample standard deviation. So if we look at the descriptives, 68 0.423 divided by 4.079 is about 16.775. This is not how most psychological researchers would compute Cohen's D. We usually want to know the difference between the sample mean and the hypothesized mean in standard deviation units. So unfortunately, we can't use the Cohen's D that JASP is computing here. The remaining additional statistics that are available here, we also won't be using in this course. Let's zoom in to the output and interpret what we have here. The t-test statistic is negative 7.287. If you were doing this by hand, this is the sample mean minus 70 divided by the standard error. Degrees of freedom are the valid sample size minus 1, and our p-value is less than 0.001. The p-value is what we use to make the decision of whether to reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis. This is a very small p-value. If the population mean were really 70, less than 0.1% of random samples of n equals 355 would have a sample mean as extreme or more extreme than the one we observed, which was 68.423. So it's very unlikely that a population with a mean of 70 would produce this sample. When the p-value is less than the alpha level, which in psychology is usually 0.05, we reject the null hypothesis. This means there is evidence that the mean height in the population of all students at this university is different from 70 inches. If I were reporting these results in APA format, I would provide the t-test statistic with degrees of freedom in parentheses, followed by the p-value. Depending on where I'm publishing, some journals will also like to have the 95% confidence interval. Others will want Cohen's D, which in this case, I would have to compute by hand.